tonight.
I can't imagine people living in this much pain. These people need help. I don't even think I can help them.
Iyanla faces a family in complete meltdown.
She's evil. She's rude.
Man, she mean as hell.
Total chaos.
So I say I don't care. I just don't care.
14 relatives under one roof.
I just want to be out of there.
A marriage about to break.
I don't care if you leave or stay, but you will speak your truth.
I'm not taking anybody's side. Y'all don't tell the truth.
Brought me here saying this woman is a witch and she's broken and damaged and you knew it.
I feel like I wasted my time.
Can this mess ever be fixed?
Mac, don't abandon your mom now.
Next.
Life happens to everybody, even me. Life didn't care that I had written a bunch of books, traveled the world speaking, married the love of my life, lived in my dream home and made a bunch of money. And then life left me broke and feeling broken. The only way to get back was to do the work. I did my work and put my life back together piece by piece. I am Iyanla Vanzant, and I am here to help you do your work.
I'm in my home state of Maryland, very close to the city I live in, because there's a family in total breakdown.
I'm here to do the work in a chaotic home packed with 14 houseguests and one angry mom.
I always say, the man builds the house, but the woman makes the home. Now, what happens if the woman isn't home in her own house? That's a problem.
Will, a local restaurant owner, has invited 14 members of his family, including 9 children, to live in his home against the wishes of his wife, Carrie.
Will and I, we just cohabitate together, basically. And it's very hard living with him treating me the way he does. It's just intolerable.
Carrie has reacted by lashing out with angry words. And in the last few months, they say she has become violent.
She hit me. She open-handedly smacked me in my face in the left side.
She's evil. She's rude. She's argumentative.
Man, she mean as hell. For what?
She's like Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde.
There's Glinda the Good Witch, and then there's the Wicked Witch of the East. And that's where Aunt Carrie falls.
My wife's just a real bitch.
Family members say that Carrie's behavior gets worse when she drinks.
Don't let Aunt Carrie know that there's a cocktail nearby because, oh, I forgot to tell you how she was a secret drunk. Did I mention that? She spends a lot of her time in her room getting lit.
Carrie says she's no longer able to live in this crazy mess, and it's destroyed her relationship with her husband.
It's just some place where he can invite his family. Yeah, you can come live with me. I'll take care of everything. I'm the man. I'm Will. I can take care of everything. You can't take care of his own wife.
Things are so bad, Carrie says she's ready to walk away from her 34-year marriage.
Unhurt, unloved, unappreciated. So much pain.
Behind the walls of this house, there's a hot mess brewing. It is important to get Miss Carrie out of this hostile household before I dig into the cause of the breakdown.
Good morning. Will the lady of the house join me?
I certainly
Everybody will. Else, I'll be right back.
Okay. On our special. Mm-hmm.
Today, you're gonna be queen for a day.
Wow.
Queen for a day. And all I need you to do is trust the process.
Okay.
Just trust the process.
Okay.
The driver's gonna tell you everything you need to know.
Okay.
Have a wonderful day, Miss Lady of the House.
Now, I want to address the other family members and house guests. There's Will, Carrie's husband, who the family calls Uncle Pumpkin. Their two children, Alexis and Mac, and Alexis's daughter, Nina. Then there's Will's nephew, Jamal, Will's sister, Renita, and Renita's four grandchildren. Renita's daughter, LaKilla, the children's mother, also lives in the house. She agreed to be here today, but then didn't show up.
I just wanted to make sure that the lady of the house was taken care of because she's a very important element. And I want to have a town meeting with the family.
Okay.
First, hold this for me while y'all get ready for your, for the town hall meeting.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to make sure that this is in place.
Before I talk with the rest of the family, I want to sit down with Will and Carrie's daughter, Alexis, who wrote to me about her mom.
She holds grudges. She's just angry. She slammed doors. Just isolate and then confront. Right or wrong, she'll confront.
Am I here because your mom is angry and creating disruption in this house? Or am I here because your mom has a drinking problem that nobody's talking about?
Disruption in the house.
Not the drinking.
I mean, it's bad, I'm not gonna lie. Like, and she's different when she's either under the influence or not under the influence. That's why I avoid her. So it's like, if she's that way, then it's like, I don't even bother.
That's a wonderful thing to do, to know that your mother may could have a drinking problem, and rather than deal with it, you avoid her. I don't know how happy you're gonna be about the fact that you wrote me. Let's go talk to the family. So, where's Killa?
She's not here.
She's not here.
Right.
But those are her children, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. Interesting. I need you to be willing to go into some places that scare you. Mm. So, are you in?
We're in.
Yes.
You're not saying nothing, you're just shaking your head. Let me hear your voice.
I'm in.
All right, because I had to hear your voice now. This is not going to look like you think it's going to look. I've not taken anybody's side here. I'm not on a side. I'm for healing. Why am I here, people? Why am I here?
We need help.
Okay, what does that mean?
We need your help. Well, my sister-in-law.
That would be Carrie?
Yes.
Okay. The lady of the house?
Yes. She has a tendency of going out of her way to make your life miserable. I can be talking to her, and one minute we're playing and we're talking, then all of a sudden, from out of the blue, she'll switch up. And I just say, okay, and I'll walk on away.
And walk away?
I'll walk away. I'm tolerating, but I can't deal with it.
In her house?
Is it not?
You can't deal with how she is. Interesting.
Yeah.
Why am I here, Jamal?
The main reason I feel as though you're here is to help us in regards to Aunt Carrie.
Lady of the house.
Correct.
She always has an attitude. Her face always looked like a pig's ass is in her face. I used to call it the witch of the house. I feel like Aunt Carrie gets on her broom and she just raised hell with everybody. I mean.
So in her house, she gets on her broom.
Yes.
And disturbs house guests. Because you're a guest here.
Yes, we are.
Interesting.
Her and I have had several altercations, and In her house. I don't care who house it is. You're not going to disrespect me. So.
Well, my. Let me just clutch my pearls.
I mean, clutch my.
Yeah, you need to clutch yours. Because if you were in my house, I would choke you with them. He's talking about your mother. Your mother. Mm-hmm. He just called your mother a witch. About his experience of her in her house.
Mm-hmm. It's not necessarily she's a bad person. It's just she's fed up. They've been married over 30-some years, and they really never had any time together. You know, always somebody's in the house. It makes sense to me.
Who responds to the fact that somebody lives in this woman's house called her a witch.
I'm over this in her house thing. Mm-hmm. I'm done.
Loose boundaries. You're done? What does that mean?
Because it's like, I feel like this is like being flipped And now we're painting this picture of this lady of the house and her house. And I mean, seriously?
So let me just say something to you. I asked you for your buy-in early on, and you said I'm in. It's not gonna look the way you think it's gonna look, Jamal. Here's an agreement I wanna talk about. The silent agreement you seem to have about not talking about the fact that Miss Carrie drinks. Either the pressure of what's going on has led her to drink, or the drinking leads to the behavior you see. And you walk away, you don't address it, you don't talk about it anymore, you don't admit it, and you the man of the house.
Yeah. And I'm sorry to say I don't care. Not to say I don't love her, but I just don't care.
She's in trouble. She's in trouble. Yes, she behaves badly. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, her mouth is foul. Yes.
This is my thing.
She's in trouble, Jamal.
She is.
People in trouble need help.
Absolutely.
And people in trouble who can't communicate on a general basis may not have the words to say, help me, I'm in trouble. See, part of the problem here is y'all don't tell the truth. Everybody tells the truth from their perspective, but not the truth of what's going on. There's a bigger truth here.
When she lost her first baby, that's when it started.
Yeah.
How did she lose the baby?
Crib death.
Sudden crib death.
That's not losing a baby. That's losing a child.
Mm-hmm. He was probably a week. Maybe
a week old.
Yeah.
So a week after a woman gives birth to her baby, she comes to the crib and finds him dead.
Yeah. She started drinking, and it was always, no matter what was in the house, it was gone.
Let me just go in the bush and weep. Let me just go in the bush and weep. I just have to go in the bush and weep. Really. I don't understand. I swear to God, I don't understand. These people need help. I don't even think I can help them. They need help.
I'm in Maryland to help a husband and wife whose full house is tearing their marriage apart. Husband Will has invited 14 members of his family, including 5 adults and 9 children, to live in his home without consulting his wife, Carrie, and she is mad as hell.
She hit me. She open-handedly smacked me in my face.
She's evil. She's rude. She's argumentative.
My wife's just a real bitch.
After removing Carrie from this explosive situation, I sat down with the family.
I could be talking to her, and one minute we're playing and we're talking. Then all of a sudden, from out of the blue, she'll switch up. And I just say, okay, and I'll walk on away.
The family has failed to recognize that there's pain at the root of Carrie's bad behavior.
How did she lose the baby?
Crib death.
Sudden crib death.
That's not losing a baby. That's losing a child.
He was probably a week. Maybe
a week old.
Yeah.
Let me just go in the bush and weep. Let me just go in the bush and weep.
When a woman buries her child, everything she does is colored by that experience. Everything.
I buried a child. She was 31. Mm. There's no amount of liquor in the world that can fill that hole.
Right.
Nothing. It's in every breath I take now, 10 years later. When a woman buries a child, there's a hole in the soul that changes who she is.
Yeah.
But here's what I want you to hear, Uncle Punkin. You invited these people into your house. Somewhere along the way, Miss Carrie said, no, I don't want them here. And you let them in anyway. Your wife needed you to make her feel safe, and you didn't. You sacrificed your wife. You sacrificed your wife to be the patriarch. You brought me here saying this woman is a bitch and a witch and she's ruining everybody's life and she's broken and damaged and you knew it. Y'all call me here. I hope you'll be happy when I leave.
I'm just horrified. Horrified.
Hey, what's up?
I can't imagine people living in this much pain. I can't imagine it. And then there are 9 children in this house. These people need help. I don't even think I can help them. They need help.
After everything I've heard today, I need to speak to Miss Carrie, the lady of the house. I sent her away for some alone time. Now, I've asked her to meet me at a nearby hotel.
Miss Carrie, what? How did these people get into your house?
They're family and they need help. They're my husband's family.
So what was the conversation with your husband that these people would be in your house?
I was informed like a day or so before they actually moved in, so.
You were informed?
I was informed. I wasn't asked.
The thing that everybody says about you is about.
They say I'm angry.
Are you angry?
The fact that my whole entire family have my personality so misconstrued. They just only see when I'm angry or, you know, when I'm upset.
And then I had a conversation with Miss Nita, who said that you and her do get along well at times, but that at any moment you flip, and when you do, she just walks away and leaves you.
Okay.
You don't have that experience.
I don't flip on Nita.
That's her experience that you do.
Okay.
But
I've
saying,
never flipped
you think
on
you and Renita get along, and she thinks okay, that you'll do until you flip.
Mm-hmm. I got good reason to flip.
No,
and I'm going to flip some more. I'm going to do a whole lot of flipping.
Okay. I hear that, and I'm not saying that you don't have a reason to flip.
And I'm going to flip right out the door.
So are you done with your marriage? Is that what you're telling me?
Yes.
Have you told your husband that you're leaving?
Nope.
So you're doing
I
this.
I will once I get my plan in progress.
Well, that's what he did. He let you know. Once he got his plan in place that Jamal was coming, he let you know. So you are doing the same thing that you say he did.
Yes, I guess so.
I had a conversation with Mr. Will today, and we talked about your son that you lost.
He actually spoke on that.
Yeah.
I don't speak on that.
Why not?
It's too painful. You never get over losing a child.
I buried one.
Damn you.
Yeah.
I'm sorry for you.
I'm sorry for you. So what do you do with that pain?
Nothing. I don't do anything with it. I pray on it.
How's that helping you, not talking about it? Because your family talks about your anger, mm-hmm. how you strike out. Is it possible that that's how you work through your pain?
That's quite possible. Quite understandable.
Yeah. But dealing with your pain in that way has created total chaos in your household.
It has. Right.
Mr. Will shared with me today that he thinks after you walked in there and found your week-old baby dead, that that's when you started drinking. Is that accurate?
No. Yeah, I mean, I probably was at that time.
I mean, it would be very understandable.
Right.
So when did you start drinking?
I was drinking during that time, but I don't make it a habit.
Oh, you don't?
No, I don't.
Everybody agreed on 2 things. One is that you were the problem, and that 2, you have a drinking problem.
Okay.
Everybody agreed on that.
All right.
What does that mean, all right?
That's what they believe. I'm in denial. I just want to be out of there.
But, Miss Carrie, when you leave there, you're taking you with you. So leaving there, Miss Carrie, is not going to change until you change.
Miss Alexis packed this bag for you.
Okay.
I tell Miss Carrie that she's staying here at the hotel tonight.
And tomorrow? I don't care if you leave or stay. I'm not invested, but you will speak your truth.
I want her to sit with her truth before she sits down with her husband, Will, tomorrow morning.
A big old sister girl hug.
All right, sister girl.
I got you. Let it out. Let it out.
Just a real mess right now.
Oh, Miss Carrie. Change comes through chaos.
Right.
Change is not pretty.
Nope.
And it's okay.
Okay.
Mac, don't abandon your mom now. You gave me your word, Mac.
I'm moving forward whether he's here or not.
Yeah. We're gonna do this no matter what.
I'm in Maryland, where a mother is lashing out in a house crowded with 14 guests, including 9 children, some of whom don't seem to be in school. Her husband, Will, invited these guests into their home, even though she never wanted them.
Real snooty, real diva.
It can be crazy. I mean, they're screaming matches, they're fights.
Where they see anger,
her mood swings, and her attitude.
You know, I feel like Aunt Carrie gets on her broom, and she just raised hell with everybody.
I see a mother in deep pain.
We talked about your son that you lost.
I don't speak on that.
Why not?
It's too painful.
If things don't change, Carrie says her marriage could be over.
I got good reason to flip. I'm gonna flip right out the door.
So are you done with your marriage? Is that what you're telling me?
Yes.
After speaking with Carrie, it's clear that there are two sides to this story.
Mr. Will, he created this. Mm-hmm. He created it. You can't be the head of the household that makes arrangements with tenants, but not the head of the household when your wife is falling apart.
Nothing is going to change until Will takes responsibility for the chaos he has invited into his house.
Mr. Will, I bought you a present.
Oh, really?
Take this from me.
Yes, thank you, Miss Iyanla.
I think this is symbolic of you, because this is your house, right? I mean,
right.
Would you consider yourself the head of this household?
Yes.
Okay, because you brought your wife here.
Mm-hmm.
You invited your sister.
Yes.
And your nephew. And a host of other people along the way. To my gift, Uncle Will. I'm gonna take him, you take the box.
Wow.
Because Uncle Pumpkin, the fish thinks from the head to the tail.
Mm-hmm.
You the head. Mm-hmm. Fish don't stink from the tail to the head.
I want Mr. Will to see that poor leadership from the head and not bad behavior from Miss Carrie is the cause of his failing marriage and unruly house.
You set the tone. You the head.
Right.
What happened that made it okay with you that people would come into your household and talk about your wife?
What made that okay was they were a relief for me. I wasn't hearing Carrie in my ear. So it was easy for me to just say, hey, she's on you guys. I can get a break.
But don't you understand, Mr. Will, that you set the tone and you gave people permission to do that?
Yeah, I didn't even realize that.
I don't understand how you know in all of this can look at Carrie's behavior and think it's evil and angry and bitchy and not sorrow and grief that has driven this woman to the bottle.
It took you to bring that out to me, but you're right. And I wasn't there for her at all. As a matter of fact, I've been so bitter, I was hoping that she would just leave. And that was because I'm just frustrated
And overwhelm.
And overwhelm.
And stuff in your own sorrow.
Mm-hmm.
And Mr. Will, you didn't have a model about how to do any of that.
So Carrie's always reminding me. That's her biggest thing. She tells me, you're just like your father. I see your father more and more today than every day. But I hated my father for one thing.
Why?
My father was a womanizer. That's why we have so many brothers and sisters. And I swore I would never be like him.
Did he ever tell you he was proud of you?
No. Never even told me he loved me.
Oh, Mr. Will.
Mm-hmm. That's how Dad raised us. That was the example that he made.
The son is going to grow up and do what he saw his father do.
Mm-hmm.
It's called the pathology. It's the pattern. And it goes generation to generation to generation. And while you may not be a womanizer in the street, you got your sister and killer. These are the women you got living in your wife's house.
Mm-hmm.
Can I tell you something? It's really, really hard for a woman to have another woman in her house.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want another woman using my pots. I don't want another woman in my bathtub. It's hard for women to share energy, and then they don't even treat her with the respect that she's due as a woman who's birthed and raised her children. She don't even get that respect. So who is she just another tenant here?
Might as well say that's where it
because
is. Because the head allowed it.
I'm gonna help you do better, Mr. Will, because you're willing. You're willing. And I think you love Carrie enough to want to save her.
I do.
Now I'm ready to talk to Will and Carrie's son, Mac. But my producers tell me he's upset after being challenged for not standing up for his mother. He's left the house and abandoned the process. What happened?
Carrie is on the phone with Mac right now, who left. Very upset.
Let me talk to him. Tell me what you're upset about, darling. Mac, don't abandon your mom now. Don't abandon your mom. You gave me your word, Mac. You sure can. He wants to talk to his father. Mac wants to talk to you.
Mac, you need some healing yourself.
I would want him to be involved in the healing of the nucleus.
Yes.
But, you know, I'm moving forward whether he's here or not.
Yeah.
He may come back. It's kind of hard to read.
We're going to do this no matter what.
Right now, I just don't know what I'm about to walk into.
So it's day two here in Maryland. I'm working with a family in deep, deep crisis and turmoil. But I'm hopeful.
Good morning.
Mr. Will.
How are you?
Uncle Pumpkin.
That's Uncle Pumpkin. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good.
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 So let me tell you what our plan is for today. I want to support you and Miss Carrie in having a conversation where you can maybe share with her some of your realizations from yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
She can share with you some of hers.
Mm-hmm.
I want to see where you guys get to because you are the core.
Mm-hmm.
You and Miss Carrie.
Right now, I just don't know what I'm about to walk into. I'm hopeful now that Iyanla is here that our family can get back on track the way we should be. If it doesn't work out that way, then that's gonna be a sad day. Sad situation.
I think Miss Carrie's here, so why don't we go greet her?
Hi. She looks nice.
Hello.
How you doing?
Okay.
Yeah.
How you doing?
Come on.
Good morning.
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 Look beautiful. Is that how you greet your husband?
Good morning.
Recently, yeah.
All right, well, we're gonna talk about that too.
This house is full of challenges, but at its foundation is a couple who just don't trust each other. Unless that changes, this house will come tumbling down.
The thing that interrupts intimacy and connection quicker than anything else is a violation of trust. Mr. Will, we talked yesterday about the times when Miss Carrie felt that you weren't there to protect her, that she didn't feel safe, about the promises you made to your beloved that you didn't keep, about the times you disappointed her. Those things still live in her heart. You two have to be willing to forgive each other and let that go. But Mr. Will, you've got to take ownership and responsibility for the number of failures and the number of disappointments that you have walked her through without an explanation. You got to own it, Mr. Will.
Yeah.
Yes, Miss Carrie. Yeah.
It's a painful thing when you have to... hold so many of your feelings inside because...
Because?
If I let my feelings out...
Yeah.
I feel he won't see the vulnerability. He'll see it as a weakness.
Oh, yeah. Let's test it. Let's test it. Look at your husband and tell him, I am afraid to be vulnerable with you.
I'm afraid to be vulnerable with you.
Because?
Because I didn't think you cared.
Yes.
I do care.
Well, move in and let her know. Okay. Move in and let her know you care. Let her know you care.
I love you. I care. I do.
And let her know, please forgive me. For not being able to show you I care.
Show you I care.
Tell her, I was so busy.
I was so busy.
Trying not to be like my father. Tell her. Tell her.
Trying not to be like that.
I didn't know who to be like.
I didn't know who to be like.
Yeah, you were right, baby. I ended up doing to you what he did to my mother.
What he did to my mother. Please forgive me.
Please.
I do love you, baby.
And I missed you.
I missed you.
Y'all have to learn how to hold on to each other in the hard times. This man is not gonna hurt you. That don't mean he's always got good behavior, but he loves you.
Oh, wow.
Y'all have to relearn this thing right here.
We did it for over 30-some years.
Yeah.
You haven't forgot.
You just gotta stop being mad at each other. Mr. Will, think higher of her. Even when she behaves badly. Miss Carrie,
yes.
Think higher of him. Even when he behaves badly.
Think higher.
Think higher. That's what love looks like when you take the crazy mint out of the middle. It was just crazy mint. Bad behavior, wrongdoing, and crazy mint. Trust love. Trust love. Don't hear that this as an attack. We're trying to create a new
way. It's not an attack. It's just like I could have been handling the rest of my business to make sure my stuff be done today instead of sitting here listening to a bunch of bull crap. That's how I honestly feel. I feel like I done wasted my time.
For the past 2 days, I've been doing the work with a husband and wife on the brink of divorce.
I do love you, baby.
I love you.
I missed you.
Now that Mr. Will and Miss Carrie are on the same page, it's time for them to get their chaotic house in order.
Hello.
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 Will and Carrie's son, Mac, has abandoned the process.
How's everybody?
Good.
But Will's niece, LaKilla, who lives in the house with her four children, is finally joining us.
So, one of the things that I've been talking to Mr. Will, Uncle Punkin, and Miss Lady about is really how to structure this so that it works for everybody. You know? I introduced Uncle Punkin yesterday to the fish. Share with them what you learned about the fish.
If the head is not leading, then the whole fish stinks. I'm the head. I'm gonna lead y'all as best I can.
And the reason the fish can move is not just because of the head, but because it has fins, yeah? And Miss Carrie is the fins.
I'm the fins.
Yeah. So what do you want to share with the village about what you've learned, Miss Carrie?
By not communicating properly, that I was holding a tremendous amount of pain and hurt within. I'm so thankful that my daughter called you. I needed a healing. And I feel the healing coming.
I want you to stand up in your choice, Miss Carrie. Stand up, because, you know, sometimes if we don't stand in the choice, we forget it.
Forget it.
Yeah, go ahead. What is the choice that you're making?
The choice that I have made is to, I'm done with alcohol. I'm going to do away with it for the next 30 days.
Yes.
That's the start, right? Thank you. Thank you.
I agreed to go 30 days, too.
Yeah. Wow. Hey, got you back on that.
He ain't tell us that.
How about we all go 30 days? No. Right. I will too.
30 days?
30 days.
Commitment. 30 days.
After being in this house for the past few days, I've noticed that LaKilla's children have not been going to school. If Carrie's going to own her position as the lady of the house, she needs to address this head on.
Miss Carrie, is there anything you need to share with Miss Killa?
Killa, I wrote you a letter last night. I have to be honest, Killa, in my observation of you and the children, I would like to see them in school.
Okay. So, can I speak?
Absolutely.
Oh, okay. It's not, they're not in school. They like doing homeschooling, so.
Now, do you have a homeschool curriculum that you're using with them?
Yes.
Okay. Don't hear this as an attack. We're trying to create a new
way. It's not an attack. It's just like I could have been handling the rest of my business to make sure my stuff be done today instead of sitting here listening to a bunch of bull crap. That's how I honestly feel. I feel like I done wasted my time.
You
okay?
can leave at any
That's
moment.
That's what I was just about to tell you, that I'm actually about to leave.
Okay.
Mr. Will and Miss Carrie have come a long way in reestablishing order in their chaotic household. But not everyone is ready for change in this moment.
Don't hear that this as an attack. We're trying to create a new
It's not an attack. It's just like I could have been handling the rest of my business to make sure my stuff be done today instead of sitting here listening to a bunch of bull crap. That's how I honestly feel. I feel like I done wasted my time.
You can leave at any
That's
moment.
That's what I was just about to tell you, that I'm actually about to leave. I'm out, okay?
And that's okay. In the village, sometimes some people choose not to participate. People can only do what they can do. We've got to support her in doing and being better. And tolerating bad behavior is not the way we help people do better. I didn't come here to do therapy. I came here to address a problem, okay? Mr. Jamal, I'm gonna ask you to stand and voice your commitment to this family for moving forward.
My commitment for going forward is definitely respect where respect is due.
Hold that thought. Come here, Aunt Carrie. Come here. Let me just do this one last little piece of business. Look at this baby. This baby.
Okay. I love
you.
I love you, too.
I want to start with you. Look at him. Repeat after me. I'm so, so sorry.
I'm so sorry.
I let my pain poison our relationship.
Poison our relationship. Please forgive me.
I do.
Love you. Love you too.
Yesterday, Miss Carrie had one foot out the door, but today she is standing in her position as lady of the house.
I'm so thankful that my husband, the way he, the courage was so...
Was it sexy?
I was not. Honey, that was a turn on.
Oh!
I am happy. I have to thank you so much. You have given me the tools that I'm going to need in order to bring about a positive change in the family here. And I think we're going to be doing a lot better.
Yeah. Thank you, Miss Carrie.
Thank you.
Awesome.
First of all, let me do one thing before I go.
Oh, oh, oh. Oh. Hey.
So I'm going to take my sign. When I started here yesterday, I have to tell you that for the first time in 30 years that I've been doing this work, 30 years, I wept with sorrow at the depth of the pain and suffering that I saw. Now my heart weeps with joy that the fish got ahead. My work here is done.
I feel good. Can we get a hug, group hug?
Yeah. Oh, I said that earlier.
Oh, you wish it.